In this video, we're going to be looking at how to find the area of a rectilinear shape. So we have been finding the area of rectangles. And for that, we've been multiplying length times width because there's that invisible square array inside each rectangle. So we've been able to be more efficient by just multiplying length times width and finding how many square units are in that shape or in that invisible array. Well, here we have a rectilinear shape, and all a rectilinear shape is a shape made of rectangles joined together. So if we can find the area of regular rectangles, we can find the area of a rectilinear shape. We just have to do a few more steps. So the first step is you have to make sure you have all the outside lengths. And so what I like to do is I just like to run my finger over each side and make sure that each side has a length. Now today we have a length for each of them. In another video, I'll show you some strategies for when you have a missing side. But for this one, we're starting pretty simple. So here I have all my sides. So now I need to break it apart into two rectangles, okay? Because then I can find the area of a rectangle. We've already done that. For this shape, you find a corner and then you break it apart to make a rectangle. So here I could break it apart here and have a top and a bottom rectangle, or I could break it apart here and have two side-by-side rectangles. Either way is going to get you the same total area because nothing's changing about our rectilinear shape. It's just it'll change what multiplication equations I use. So you could kind of practice that with your third grader, breaking it apart in different ways and seeing that you're still getting the same total area. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to break it apart right here. Right there, I'm breaking it apart. So now I've made a rectangle here, which I can find the area of, and a rectangle here, which I can find the area of. The tricky part is making sure that you're using the side lengths that are safe to use, and you'll see why I'm kind of calling some sides safe to use. For example here, this side here, number 10 inches, the whole thing is 10 inches, but now for this rectangle, I'm only using this part of it. And for this rectangle, I'm only using this part of it. So 10 is not really a safe side to use anymore. Same with this 3 here. 3 was just this portion, but I've actually made the 3 even longer. I've extended it. So 3 really isn't safe for me to use anymore to find the area of this rectangle. But what I am going to use to start off here by ignoring this one first is I do know that 6, it hasn't been touched, so that's a safe side for me to use, and 8 is safe. So to find the area of this rectangle, I'm going to do 6 times 8, and that is 48 square inches for this rectangle. But that's not the total area of my rectilinear shape. Now let me look over here. Safe side to use. Again, 10 is not safe, so I need to look around here. Oh, 2 and 3 are safe because I haven't done anything with them. So I'm going to do 2 times 3 equals 6 square inches. Now, remember, this is 48 square inches for this rectangle. This is 6 square inches for this rectangle. But in order to find the whole area of the rectilinear shape, I need to just join them together. So I'm going to do 48 square inches plus 6 square inches. And that gives me 54 square inches. So follow these steps when you are trying to find the area of a rectilinear shape. Make sure you have all the outside lengths because the outside lengths will help you find the inside area. Most of the sides will be helping you. Then you need to break it apart. Remember, there's no right or wrong way to break it apart as long as you're breaking it so that you're making rectangles because we can find the area of a rectangle. Then you need to multiply using safe sides, sides that haven't been broken up or sides that haven't been extended to be longer, using those safe sides to find the area of each rectangle. And then you just add the smaller areas together to get the larger rectilinear area. So follow those steps when you are working with rectilinear shapes.